Venkatesh. Notices have been pasted now outside his Juhu residence to begin with, and that's the plan forward. As for the Mumbai Police Crime Branch, when it did declare him a proclaimed offender before declaring him an absconder, it said that if you don't appear before the agency within the next 30 days back then, which means 25 days from now, you're going to be declared an absconder. But Paramveer Singh, through his lawyer in the top court, says there's threat to his life, though he's ready to appear before the CBI. If the CBI investigates the case, what do you make of the current situation, sir?
It's messy. It's concocted. And of course, it doesn't meet the eye. But be that as it may, look at it. The lower court has declared him to be an absconder, and most probably the law sets in motion and the forfeiture of all his assets will begin. But here is the top cop of the country, not only of the state, but of the country. He's a very, very respected and a very, very senior police officer. Comes back and tells us that his life is in danger for any investigation to be conducted against him in this case, which involves one of the of Maharashtra. If that is the state of affairs in Maharashtra, all right-thinking people of Maharashtra, all Indian citizens, all those concerned people have to step back and just answer this question. What is the state of affairs in Maharashtra? Is it a jungle raj that is prevailing? Is this government doing something as per the constitutional mandate? Or is it doing something what we call as a jungle law? If the topmost cop of the state is feeling unsafe on an investigation to be conducted by the state police, something is terribly wrong. And I hope the authorities, I hope the agencies, the judiciary, the media, all ask this pertinent question. What is happening in the state of Mr. Thackeray? What is happening there? I think there is no other parallel in this last 70 years of our independence where we have seen this happening. Unfortunately, what is happening here is one of the lowest point in our independence. And I hope relentless pursuit of justice as the Republic is doing today, which has been carrying on for such a long time, I think sees a logical conclusion. Yay, in Mr. Paramveer Singh coming and deposing before the police and he's taken into custodial interrogation. And he comes out with the truth as what happened between him, Vazey, and Anil Deshmukh. The nation has a right to know what happened, what transpired with them, what was the tactical support they were providing to Anil Deshmukh. It is not that the police can say that I was doing something illegal at the behest of a home minister of the state. This complete breakdown of machinery, of law and order, and I hope the central government and the president also looks into it as to what the hell is happening in the state of Maharashtra.
Absolutely, MR. I also want to ask you, thank you, MR, for answering that. I also want to ask you, there are many agencies actually that probably want to interrogate Paramveer Singh. There are many agencies that probably want to cross-question him with Sachin Vazey and or Anil Deshmukh, because only then maybe you will find out the true series of events, because there was a hierarchy at play there. Now, what I want to ask you is, what happens next? If the Mumbai crime branch has pasted a notice at his door, does that mean, in accordance with the Supreme Court order, that he has to show up before the Mumbai crime branch? What if some other agency asks to interrogate him? What if the NIA, for instance, asks to interrogate Paramveer? What do you think will happen then, MR?
I think he has to answer all the agencies. That is my reading of the Supreme Court's order. He cannot say that I will choose my agency and I will not choose to go in front of certain agencies. He has to go in front of the Mumbai police. He has to go before CBI. He has to go before NIA. All the three are unfortunately separate, but at interlinked. They are separate because each one is a separate offense, separate crime, separate agencies are looking into it. But they are all linked, tectonically linked, because they are all involving the same set of characters. And the modus operandi was extortionism, use the power, use it like a mafia with no latent fear. And even if there is an interference from any state agency or judiciary, they will use their power in a countervailing manner to see that those judicial interferences or interference by anybody is distinctly negative. So that is how these people were working. So this is not a simple law and order issue. This is a complete breakdown of law and order. This is a complete breakdown in which the entire state administration, constitutional machinery has been wrecked from within. This is a lesson for all of us. And I'm glad that only Republic media has been pursuing this case. I see absolute silence, death, completely death-like silence, funereal silence by all other media. I only hope that Republic continues to pursue this story and takes it to a logical conclusion.
Thank you, Mr. Venkatesh, for that and for really sharing that perspective with our viewers this afternoon. Quickly bringing in Ananya into the conversation as we take this forward, and Yesha is also, I believe, with us as Ankit continues to stay with us as well. Now, Ananya, like Mr. Venkatesh was pointing out, and Ankit has also been saying, there are several players involved, and that's what the investigating agencies are essentially looking at, that if let's say two players in the case are being investigated, interrogated, then why is it that Parambir Singh gets the easy way out? And that's exactly what multiple agencies have been maintaining at this point in time. It's not just one agency that wants to question him in regards to the extortion case to begin with. It is him who wrote that letter to the Chief Minister alleging that it was former Home Minister Anil Deshmukh who asked Sachin Waze to collect 100 crore rupees per month. So those are serious allegations that must be investigated in detail. Sachin Waze, on the other hand, says he's just a pawn. There are bigger players involved. So each of them at the moment pinning the blame on the other, conveniently trying to exit and, you know, not really be involved. But that's certainly not what's going to happen, isn't it? The investigating agencies have made it very clear that all of them have had a role to play and that must be investigated in detail. Yesha? Sorry, Ananya, I beg your pardon. Ananya, that was for you.
So, basically, first of all, that when the investigation agency would come in, they've already come in, and when things come before one of them, and as Mr. Venkatesh was also pointing it out, that multiple agencies...
We are having troubles, Ananya, with your phone line. We'll get back to you. Advocate Kapil Madan is joining us. Mr. Kapil Madan, thank you so much for speaking to us today on a day when a notice of proclaimed offender has been pasted on Parambir Singh's doors. The first thing we'd like to ask you is, now what does he have to do? What if the Mumbai police and crime branch have summoned him? Does he have to show up immediately or does he have 30 days? Because the Supreme Court has asked him to show up. But what is the timeline for this?
So, see, you need to understand what the Supreme Court has said. You know, Supreme Court has, you know, stayed his arrest. So, technically, he will not be arrested if he is produced before, you know, any of the authorities. However, the process to, you know, declare him as a proclaimed offender is on. Now, what usually happens is that, you know, once the notice is issued and the notice is affixed at their usual place of business, simultaneously, there would be a publication, you know, in the newspaper also, and a date will be given in the newspaper asking him to appear on a particular date. And if he does not show up, the person who has affixed these notices has to report back to the court to satisfy to the court that the due process was followed, and thereafter he will be declared as a proclaimed offender. However, I feel now, since he has a protection from the Supreme Court, I mean, his legal team will advise him to appear before he is actually declared him as a proclaimed offender, because being declared as a proclaimed offender is also an offence under Section 174.
Right. I want to ask you another question. I'm a little bit perturbed, Kapil, that there's only one notice pasted there, because there are so many investigations that have been lodged against him. There are 5 extortion FIRs, maybe an NIA probe also. There is also the Chandiwal Commission. Why is there only the one? Why is there the only one? We also have, Kapil, I request you to stay with us. We have Advocate Deshratan Nigam also joining us. Let me take that to you, Mr. Deshratan Nigam. Why is there only one notice pasted outside that door? He has been missing for over 200 days and there are so many probes lodged against him. Shouldn't there be more notices there?
See, every court will take its own decision, right? And the matter is before the courts, and if he's absconding, the process, as soon as the process matures, the notice of is pasted on the residence. And I do not know the status of the cases in all the courts. If this notice has come, that means the process of Section 82 in the CRPC has started for Parambir. And if he doesn't appear before the court, even Supreme Court has said we have to know the whereabouts. Otherwise, we will not give you any relief. So that process of Section 82 will start, and once he does not, you know, appear, then he will be declared as an absconder, proclaimed absconder. Then his property can be attached. So those are the things. These are very, very serious things. and notices will start coming in other cases also as soon as the process of 82 starts.